Hello students and welcome to lecture series on food processing equipment design. In today's lecture, we will see design of pneumatic conveyor. Pneumatic conveyor is a device which is used for conveying the material from one place to another, but here we use air or nitrogen as a mode of conveying. Instead of using a belt or something, we are using air as a or fluid as a mode of conveying. So by the definition, pneumatic conveyors are used to move fine particles. Pneumatic conveyors are used to move fine and dry particle using pressure differential. Okay, so when we flow air from one end to another, what happens? It causes a pressure difference at different places. Okay, if we are sucking air or we are flowing air, it one side will be the higher pressure side and another side will be the lower pressure side. Because of this pressure potential difference, the movement of particle occurs. So, and one more thing, that particle should be dry and very fine in nature. Okay, so if we are dealing with the wet particles or wet material, we can't use pneumatic conveyor for conveying the material. Okay, so the fluid can be a compressed air or nitrogen. The material is totally enclosed with the tubes. Here we can see pneumatic conveyor is a closed type conveying system. So the material is enclosed in the tubes or the pipes with a difference in the pressure at the ends. Okay, suppose we are trying to flow the material from this end to that end. At that case, the pressure here at this end will be higher than the pressure at this end. Okay, so Pi, in this case Pi is more than Po. Okay, because of this pressure difference, the material passes from one place to another. And the pressure difference can be made by increasing or decreasing the pressure on either side by addition of a blower or a motor. Okay, so how we can control the pressure? We have to provide a motor or a blower so that pressure can be controlled and we can cause a pressure difference. So there are two types of system in a pneumatic conveying. So first is push systems. So, which is also known as positive pressure system, in which the material is pushed from one inlet to another outlet. Okay, so like we are blowing something. Okay, this will be a positive pressure system in which we are creating the positive pressure inside the tube. So here, if we are attaching a motor here at this end, okay, then motor will or blower will, what it will do, it will blow the air inside the system. So it will create a positive pressure at this inside the conveyor. So that's why it is a push type system, or air will push the material to go to the outlet. So it is a push type or a positive pressure system. And another type system is negative pressure system or pull type system. So in pull type system, what we'll have, we are having a suction pump or a blower at the end of the conveying system. In that, the suction pump will suck or pull the material towards itself. Okay, suction pump will pull the material towards itself. That's why it will cause negative pressure inside the tube. Okay, so inside the conveyor it will cause the negative pressure. That's why it is a negative pressure system or pull type system. So we have seen types of pneumatic conveyor, like what are the two mechanisms of pneumatic conveyors. So there are types of pneumatic conveyors depending upon their conveyor type. Okay, the conveying mechanism. So first one is a dilute phase pneumatic conveyor. Second one is a dense phase pneumatic conveyor. Third one, semi-dense phase conveyors. Okay, so these things are the like depending upon the material and the fluid mixing, okay, or the phases of them, it depends upon those things. And it all these systems are pressure or vacuum driven systems, okay. So these three phases are depending upon the air flow rate or the fluid flow rate with the material characteristics. So we will see all these three phases or all three types one by one. So first one is the dilute phase. This is the diagram for a dilute phase system in which a material is supplied with the help of a hopper, and these are the material to causing the positive pressure inside the conveying system. So our conveying system starts from here and the air will be passed from this end. This is a filter, inlet air filter, and this is a motor or a pump which we use to blow the material, okay, and the air inside the system. And when the material will feed from the hopper, again there are filters and the leak valves so that the material can be filtered before entering the system. So this is a feeder controller, so which will control the feed. And when air and feed will mix to each other inside the conveying system, air will come from here. Now with the help of blowed air, the material will be passed and it will be sent to the outlet, okay. At the outlet again we will having a filter so that we can filter out the air from the system, okay, and so that we'll get the material here. So this is a typical dilute phase system. So in dilute phase we only transfer non-fragile material, the material which can sustain the losses like impact, okay, this type of forces the material can sustain, those type of material only will try to flow through this type of system, because there is an impact between, even there will be a collision between two like particles of the material with each other, okay, at any point, and at the when bends there will be collision between bend or a wall material to the material, and even with the walls there can be a collision between walls and the material. So if the material is fragile which we are passing, then that material can break, okay, and lose its properties. That's why we try to avoid the fragile material. So we only use non-fragile material, and the type of conveying we are going to use is low pressure and high velocity, okay. The pressure inside the system is low, but the velocity of the air blown will be very high. That's why like the collision will be more in this case, because the velocity of the particle will be high, and with if that velocity a particle is hit or causing impact to the wall or to the bend, or if they are colliding with the high velocity, then there are high chances of breakage of material, okay. So breaking here can be like milling, crushing, like crushing of material will occur. That's why this type of conveying system are not suitable for non-fragile materials. So dilute phase vacuum conveying are also reduce the risk of exposure to inside material, making it's useful for chemical and toxic application. So the risk of exposure to inside materials are minimized in case of dilute phase system, okay. So that's why we can use a toxic or like volatile materials in this. And noetic conveying find useful for conveying light and non-absorbing material. So dilute phase of type of material is a fast conveying of material. That's why it is mostly used for the light material and non-adhesive material. Anyway, pneumatic conveying is mostly used for non-adhesive material, but when the material is too light, okay, like if we are conveying moringa leaves, okay, or cut tea leaves, in that case we can use this dilute phase of conveying. here the value will be high and the pressure will be low, and we are dealing with the non-fragile material. So this type of conveyor need less space and are cheaper. And another reason we use pneumatic conveyors, because pneumatic conveyors are having very less components when compared to the other type of conveyors. Okay, so if we compare it with screw conveyors, we are having screw auger, shaft, motors. Okay, then we are having this duct. So whereas in type of pneumatic conveyor, we are only having a blower and a pipe, so that we can convey the system from one end to another. So the components are very less, so the cost of this pneumatic conveyors are usually very less. Coming to the next phase, which is dense phase. Here the thing which is changing is pressure and velocity. So previously we were using a very low pressure and very high velocity, but in dense phase the pressure is very high and the velocity is very low. Because of that nature, the particles inside the material, sorry, inside the fluid will be very less. That's why it's a dense phase. Okay, so density of these things will be high. Okay, because the particles are more in the system. Here we can see the particles are more in the pipe because the velocity is less. So by the time it is like, it is a slow type system. Okay, it won't convey the material very fastly. That's why it's a slow system. So head increase will be very small in this dense type systems. So what is the reason we are using dense type system? Because the dense type systems can be used for a fragile material. Okay, so there the material was flowing with very high velocity, but here the material are flowing with very less velocity. Okay, very slowly the materials are flowing. Okay, instead of flowing, materials are like, you can say, jumping and moving to the next position. Okay, it will always not be in suspended state in dense phase pneumatic conveying. Okay, so material, if this is our conveyor, okay, conveying pipe, and material is here, what will happen? First material will settle, and when air was blowing, the material will jump and move to the next position here. Okay, then material will settle for some time here, and when the air pressure comes, the material will jump to its next position. So it is like material will moving very slowly and jumping to the next position. Okay, so previously, whereas in the previous system the material was flowing, okay, with the help of velocity. But here the material are jumping or moving to the next position very slowly. That's why this type of system can be used for fragile material also. And the product is not fluidized, that we have discussed already in the airstream. Instead, it is pulsed, like that jumping or settling, and again jumping and settling is known as pulsing. Okay, so that motion, instead of getting fluidized in the system, the material is pulsed throughout the system. Okay, and the dense phase conveyors are therefore much slower, that we have discussed, when compared to the dilute phase. Okay, and the common application of dense phase pneumatic conveyors are moving heavy and bulk density material products. Okay, here we are moving heavy materials and high density materials, okay, like sugar, salt, blending product, plastic pellets, etc. So we can use even fragile materials also. So next phase is semi dense phase pneumatic conveyor. So we have seen dense phase, we have seen dilute phase. This semi dense phase pneumatic conveyor lies in between both. Okay, so we can say that this is a mixture of fast conveying, like it is not too slow conveying and it is not even too fast conveying. Okay, so like for delicate materials which are not that fragile in nature, for that type of material we can use semi-dense or semi-dense phase pneumatic conveying. Okay, semi-dense phase pneumatic conveyors are middle point between the last two conveying system we have seen, and have the quality of both as a result. So it is a in the middle of both of the systems. So the material here will be pressurized, and air, and it also moves with the air. Okay, so we are going to pressurize the system. The pressure will be high, the velocity will be high in this case. Okay, and not too high velocity, not too high pressure, but a moderate pressure will be there, and a moderate velocity of air will be there, so that the movement of the particles can be due to pressure as well as the velocity. So semi-dense pneumatic conveyors tends to be chosen, dense dilute conveyors, and do not work as they provide some increased speed. Okay, yet they still protect the material throughout the system. Okay, so the speed here of conveying, the speed of conveying in this case will be increased when compared to the dense phase system. And the semi-dense conveyors find uses moving cement, fly ash and more after the optimum solution, and needs medial ground pneumatic conveyor. Okay, so which type of material we can convey here? Can be dry ash, cement or powder material which are non-adhesive in nature, and we can move those type of material in semi-dense phase. So we have seen all three phases or all three types of pneumatic conveyors. Now we will see how to select a conveyor. Okay, so first criteria will be the distance, flow rate and pipe design. So if you are talking about distance, then how much distance we have to convey. Okay, suppose we have to go from point A to point B, then this is the distance we have to convey. But our all the type of means all our pneumatic conveying systems are pressurized conveying system, so pressure is inversely proportional to the distance travel. That's why as we increase the distance, okay, so as we are increasing the distance, the pressure will be decreased. Okay, so like we need more energy to convey the material for longer pipe, okay, or for a longer distance. So pressure will be the one thing, another will be the rate of transferring. Okay, so in this case, if we are flowing more material, okay, so density of the material and the air is high, we are flowing more material through the system, then we need more power. So power is directly proportional to the mass flow rate. So mass flow rate of material is high, then we need more power. So that's how we are going to select. Or pipe design, if there are so many bends, okay, or the pipe diameter is too big, then we need more pressure, okay, because the losses will be more inside the pipe. Okay, so means if the bends are there or length is too big, okay, length is greater, even the diameter is greater, for all these things we need more power. Okay, so with the distance it is inversely proportional, the pressure is inversely proportional to a distance. That's why with the distance power, if we relate power and distance, then we need more power to travel more distance. it is directly proportional. When we see the flow rate, then the flow rate is directly proportional to the power required to move the particles, and even these bands, even length, all those things diameter, if it is greater, then we need more power. Okay, so the design or the geometry of the pipe is also depends or also influence the power required to convey the system, convey the material from one end to another. So we have seen how these things are influencing the selection of our pneumatic conveyor. After that comes the how we can select the filter, fan, vents or other types of protection. So if the product is dusty, okay, or the irritable or toxic, in that case we used to filter the material. Okay, we need a filter equipment to protect both staff as well as the conveying system. Okay, if our material is dusty, in that case we need filters. Okay, so filters, so improving filtering can lead to some nasty issue like including repairs, replacements. So if the filtration is not proper, okay, so improper filtering, if the filtration is not proper, then it will increase the repair cost or replacement of parts. So that's why we should have adequate number of filters. Whenever we are using a pneumatic conveying system, the fan selection depends upon the which type of material and what is the length we are going to convey. Okay, so on that things a fan selection depends. Okay, how much power we are going to use, what is the velocity we are going to move the material. Okay, and other specialization are deeply interrelated, and right mixture quality, but the safety and the adequateness should always be top priority. Okay, so whenever we are designing a pneumatic conveying system, our safety and effectiveness should be the top priority whenever we are selecting these vents or fans or filters. Next come the controls and specialization consideration. The pneumatic conveying can be controlled by closed feedback or another control system. So we use another control system to control the pneumatic conveyor. So ensure the system has adequate instrumentation that will allow the troubleshooting in case of error. Okay, whenever we are designing a system, we should see whenever there is an error, the troubleshooting, then it should, this equipment should auto cut off the power. Okay, in case of spark, in case of failure of motor, okay, in any case the material should, the system should stop itself. That should be controlled by the control system. Okay, so we have to check before finishing the design, we have to see whether it is, that control system is adequate or not. Okay, and the functionality of these conveyors is highly depend upon the material they are conveying. And ensure the working characteristics of material as well as potential variation between the batches of the same material. So the functionality of the conveying material depends upon the material we are conveying. Okay, so even the, like if we are using same material, then how to compare the efficiency? We will use same material twice or thrice and then we will find out the conveying efficiency of the conveyor. So these were the criteria how to select pneumatic conveyor system. Now designing of pneumatic conveyor system. So in that first point is we have to finalize the conveying velocity. This is step one in designing of conveying system, conveying velocity and volumetric air flow rate. So what do you mean by volumetric air flow rate? It is the flow of the air inside the system. Okay, how much, what is the flow of the air? Okay, how much air we are passing through the system? So that will go give you the volumetric flow rate. So it is a free air that is normally normal ambient air that is passes through the conveying system with a velocity of UG1. Okay, UG1 is the velocity of the air passing through the system. V is the volumetric flow rate, means meter cube per second or meter cube per minute or meter cube per hour. Okay, so how much volume of the air is passing through a system, okay, in 1 second. So here D is the diameter of conveying pipe. So this is the system. So what is the volume of air, which is volumetric flow rate? Okay, so velocity of this air is UG1, diameter is D, T1 and T1 are the pressure and the absolute temperature at inlet. What is the P1? What is the temperature of air at inlet? And P0 and T0 are the pressures, absolute temperature at end. Okay, absolute temperature means 273 plus whatever temperature we are dealing with in degree Celsius. Okay, so this will be in Kelvin. Okay, so this is absolute temperature. Here also same, 273 plus T0. T0 will be in terms of degree Celsius, and this T0, capital T0, is in terms of Kelvin. Clear? So P1 and T1 will be the inlet pressure and absolute temperature. P0, T0 is the outlet pressure and outlet absolute temperature. D will be diameter of the pipe. U will be the velocity of the air. It will give you the volumetric flow rate. After this, second one is solid mass flow ratio. Okay, here the solid mass flow and the solid loading ratio we have to find out. What is solid mass flow rate? Solid mass flow rate is the solid throughput as the number of tons of the bulk solids to be transferred in 1 hour. Okay, so it is the how much material we are passing in 1 hour from the system. That will give you the solid throughput. Okay, that will give you the solid mass flow rate. We'll identify the solid mass flow rate, which is the weight of the material which is passing through the conveyor in 1 hour. Okay, and the ratio of design flow rate to the specified hourly rate will depend upon the type of batch system is used. What is the, like, we will design our conveyor for a certain flow rate, okay, and there will be a specified, like, in 1 hour what will be the flow rate we will design, and that will be influenced by the what is the batch system we are using. Okay, so what is the typical design flow rate ratio is 1.25 with twin blow tank systems and 1.5 for single blow tank system. Okay, in 1 ton batch, if the our batch size is 1 ton, okay, and what will be the flow rate, like design flow rate to the specified hourly rate. Suppose we need to like our specified flow rate is 1000 kgs per hour. This is the flow rate we need to convey the material, okay, which is specified flow rate. And we design our conveyor for this, okay, because we have to design it for a higher range. Now the ratio for both design flow rate divided by specified flow rate will give you that ratio will be used, okay, to find out what is means what should be the typical ratio? That typical ratio should be 1.25 when we are using twin blow tank system, and it should be 1.5 when we are using single blow tank system. Okay. And what do you mean by solid loading ratio? Solid loading ratio is the mass flow rate of the conveyor divided by mass flow rate of the conveying air. This is mass flow rate of So solid loading ratio means if we are supplying like 1000 kgs of air per hour and we are transporting how much material? 200 kgs of material per hour. Okay. So this air of 1000 kgs are carrying the material of 200 kgs per hour. That will be the mass flow rate of conveying bulk solid divided by mass flow rate of the air. Clear? This will give you the solids loading ratio. Next comes the pipeline diameter. Then after deciding the solid loading ratio and deciding the volumetric mass flow rate, we will find out what should be the diameter of the pipe for conveying. So formula for that is given as 4 mg upon pi rho g and ug, where mg is the mass flow rate of air. Okay, rho g is the density of air d will be the pipeline system diameter in terms of meter ug will be the conveying velocity of air or velocity of air or conveying velocity it will give you the size of the diameter of the pipe okay but sometimes this density is not given to us. For that we have to find out with the using this equation. Here this constant gas perfect gas equation is used to find out the density of air, okay, where P is the pressure, R T is the absolute time and R is the gas constant. So at a certain pressure and a temperature, what should be the density of air? Okay, that we have to find out, and that we have to put in this here. M is will be the mass flow rate of air, and UG will be the velocity of air. Once we will get the diameter of the pipe, then we'll find out the pressure drop. The formula for pressure drop is delta PS. Delta PS is equals to delta P G 1 plus alpha, where pressure loss factor is known as alpha, or we call it alpha as a solid friction coefficient. Okay, solid friction coefficient or solid friction or pressure loss factor is known as alpha. Is a complex factor of several different variables. That's why we are using alpha. Delta PG will be the pressure difference of the air. Okay, and the delta PS will be a pressure difference of or pressure drop in the flowing of gas or suspended solid. Okay, so this is the formula because this pressure drop due to the wall friction, okay, or the bends or diverters. These are the reason for the pressure drop inside the system. once we get the pressure drop, we will select the size of the air mover, means size of our motor. So how to select the size of our motor? So before selecting, we have to find out whether the system is positively pressurized system or negatively pressurized system. Okay, and there are another means various type of conveyances, means various type of criteria which we have to follow for designing the airflow system. Okay, so here we will see which type of conveying system we are planning. For example, we are going for high pressure system, okay, or a screw compressor, or a low pressure system, or a fan or root type system blower. So there are various type of system. So these systems are creating different type of like pressures, okay. The range of these systems are varying, okay. So and the volumetric flow rate is also varying. So based upon that, our requirements, we already find out what is the pressure difference we need inside our system and what is the volumetric flow rate of our system, right? These two things we have already find out previously. Now, depending upon the range of the pressure pressure difference or the pressure discharge pressure and volumetric flow rate, we will select our which type of motor or which type of compressor we are going to use for conveying the material. Suppose our volumetric flow rate is less than 50, okay, less than 50 meter cube per minute, but our pressure we need inside our system is more than 10 or 15, okay, more than 15 bar. In that case, we will use reciprocating system because the volumetric flow rate is less than 50 and the pressure we need is very high, which is more than 12 or 15. So we need reciprocating pump. Suppose our pressure is moderate and volumetric flow rate is same. Suppose our pressure is lying in between like 4 to 10 or 5 to 10, then we can go for rotary compressor, okay, or screw compressor type of air blowers, okay. Suppose our pressure is more than 1, okay, more than 1 bar, but our volumetric flow rate is very high. Pressure is less, flow is high, because it is a dilute system, right? Less pressure, okay, pressure will be less, this area, less than 1, less, but the flow rate is high, this area, okay. So here we can use either like straight lobe roots or rotary blowers, okay. Here also we can use rotary blowers. Suppose if pressure is also low, also high, and volumetric flow rate is very high, then we can go for centrifugal compressor, okay, which is having the semi-dense type of compressor. So based upon that, we will select which type of material, which type of conveyor or rotary air blower we are going to use, depending upon our pressure and the volume flow rate. Let's summarize what we have studied till now, okay. So the steps we have covered, okay. First, we selected the minimum velocity we have to transfer, okay. First, we have to find out the velocity we have to transfer from one, what should be the minimum velocity of the material which have to travel. Then we will find out the value of solid loading ratio, that is solid loading ratio we have to find out. Say if the velocity we found should be 12 meter per second, then we will find solid loading ratio. Say we got solid loading ratio as a 10, then we have to calculate the air flow rate and pipeline system diameter, okay. We need to find out what should be the air flow rate and pipeline system diameter, okay, pipe diameter. Then we will find out delta P, the pressure drop inside the system, and then we will see if the pressure drop is acceptable to achieve this velocity and this solid loading ratio, okay. If our pressure drop is okay, then we will go to step 10 directly. If it is not okay, then we have to repeat others, okay, this step 5 we have, after considering that air mover is not good, okay, we select the air mover, and air mover is, if it, sorry, for, from step 4, then we will find out after pressure drop, we will choose our air mover, okay. Then we will see whether our air mover is suitable to convey the material. If it is not, then we again go for the larger size of the pipe. Okay, we will increase the diameter of the pipe and then we will do the calculation again. Okay, and if it is correct, then we will directly go to the step 10, which is we will add additional air requirement, for example, air leak, rotary valves, other types of filter, air movers, free air deliveries, this type of things we will add, and we will try to increase the, we will try to find out the final air flow rate inside the system, and final, depending upon this final air flow rate, we will select our air mover, okay, of the higher range. So first we will find out the velocity, we will find out the solid loading ratio, then we calculate the air flow rate and the pipeline diameter. Depending upon these two, we will find out the air pressure drop, okay, and then from the air pressure drop and air pressure drop and what was that? Sorry. Air pressure drop and volumetric flow rate, based upon these two parameters, we will find out which type of air mover is needed. Okay. If our design is okay, then we will directly go to the miscellaneous calculation. Okay. Like we have to add extra pressure to the primary, means there will be bends, there will be a loss of energy. That's why we need to increase the air flow rate, and that air flow rate will again increase the size of the blower, and then we have to find a, we have to get the final size of the blower. Okay, so this is how we will design a pneumatic conveyor. Thank you. Hopefully, you liked the lecture, and if there are any doubts, we will discuss in class. Thank you.